In this video, we'll learn how to add clips to a sequence in Premiere Pro. To practice, I've got the Week 14 demo project open in Premiere, with Riley New Demo Sequence open in the Timeline panel. Before I start adding clips to this sequence, let's take a look at how our timeline is organized. And the key is in these rows. So the top three rows here, V1 through V3, all contain video or still imagery. The four tracks below the dividing line, A1 through A4, are audio tracks. So these can contain any combination of clips, and those clips might play one after another, or they might layer on top of each other to play simultaneously. To bring clips into the timeline, all we need to do is drag and drop, and we can do that from a couple of different places. The first way is to double-click on a clip from the project panel, and this opens it up in the source monitor. Here we could set the in and out points for the specific part of a clip that we're interested in working with. I've already gone ahead and done that for this clip. To bring it into the timeline, I'll just click and drag on the audio-only icon. That's the one that looks like a little waveform just above the source monitor's time ruler. This lets me drop this audio clip onto any of the four audio tracks in my sequence timeline. So I can place this anywhere I want along that timeline. In this case, I'm going to slide it all the way to the left so that it starts at the beginning of my sequence. Another way we can add clips to our sequences is directly from the project panel. So here I can just click and drag and drop any clip into my sequence. Notice that as I'm mousing over the end of the last clip I placed, my new clip is snapping right to that endpoint. So this makes it really easy to line clips up one after another without a little gap in between. Now, clips that I've already set an in and out point for in the source monitor will retain those in and out points. If I haven't done that, I'll be bringing in the clip in its entirety. In either case, we can always adjust those in and out points after we've added the clip into our sequence. Sometimes I'll know ahead of time exactly what the order of my clips should be. Other times as you're editing, it's very common to want to insert a clip in between some others that you've already laid down on your timeline. For example, I'd like to take this clip and place it in between those first two clips already in my sequence. So I'll click and drag on it. Now, as I hover over my existing clips, I'll also hold down the Command or Control key on the keyboard. When I let go of the mouse, I'm telling Premiere to insert that clip after the first one and to move the second clip farther down the timeline to accommodate all three. I could do a similar operation where I overwrite some of the existing clips in my sequence rather than inserting. For that, I just need to click and drag and drop the clip anywhere onto an existing clip. So when I do this, notice the overall length of the sequence doesn't change. That's because we've overwritten the previous clip with the new clip we just added. So at this point, we've got a set of clips in our sequence and we're ready to start playing it back and maybe doing some additional edits. We'll cover those steps in another video. For now, that's an overview of how to add clips to a sequence in Premiere Pro.